In this video, we're going to compare the eSight 3 and the eSight 4. What has changed and what has been improved? Hi everyone, it's Carrie from Live Accessible and I do videos on technology and encouragement for people who are blind and visually impaired. If you're interested in that type of video, hit the subscribe button and the bell to be notified every time I upload a video. Thank you to eSight for sending out both of these devices so I can compare them, but this is not a review of either of these devices, just a comparison of the eSight 4 and the eSight 3. If you're interested in learning more about the eSight 4, how it works, all of its features, and how it worked for me, watch this video up here. I also put it down in the description. But first, what is eSight? eSight is a low vision wearable device that uses a camera to magnify the world around you. Basically, they have a camera on the front and screens that you put right in front of your eyes, and you can zoom in, change the filters, change the mode, and using the vision that you still have, see the world better. You can use it for reading, seeing people around you and faces, as well as walking around and using the computer working, and a lot of other tasks as well. First, let us take a look at the design differences between the two. The eSight 3 is definitely a lot smaller, a lot more lightweight, but it does have a wire coming from the back right-hand side that connects to the remote. And this has all your controls, changing the zoom level, all the menus and filters and everything like that. And it has this long wire. The eSight 4, on the other hand, is a lot bigger and it is heavier than the eSight 3 because this is wireless. The battery is on the wearable, whereas the eSight 3, the battery is in the remote. The eSight 4 rests on top of your head at an angle and you can put the visor down like this. So this is how you would use the eSight 4. For the eSight 3, it looks similar to a pair of glasses and you do put them on. And there's an elastic band that goes behind your head and connects to the frame, and that helps keep the eSight 3 from falling off your head. Now, when I first saw the eSight 3 and the eSight 4 together, I really thought that I would like the eSight 3 better because of how much smaller and lighter it is. But after using it for a few days, both of these, I definitely like the eSight 4 better in my opinion. For the eSight 3, I don't know if I have a big head or something, but the sides, the temples, when I have it on, it presses into the sides of my head, and that's really uncomfortable for me. With the eSight 4, it's a lot more adjustable. It has a dial here on the top that can adjust the halo band, as well as bringing the visor closer or farther away from you. So it just feels like I can customize the fit of the eSight 4 more than the eSight 3. Also, with the eSight 4, you can pretty much wear any type of prescription glasses or even some sunglasses with the eSight 4, whereas with the eSight 3, you had to get a specific pair of glasses that were customized so that they can fit under the eSight 3. Even though the eSight 4 is heavier and bigger, it's a lot more comfortable. It's definitely very balanced because it does have the battery on the back. It has cushions all the way around the halo band, so the weight is distributed all around and it's not front heavy or back heavy like some other VR headsets can be. I really love that this is wireless. You don't have any cords that you have to worry about. Or for me, being a girl, I don't know where to put this big remote for the eSight 3. It does have a clip where you are supposed to be able to put it on your pants, but I don't know about all you other ladies out there. I don't have a place to really keep this secure. You'd have to put it in a purse maybe, but it's just kind of really big. I would definitely rather have the whole thing on my head as opposed to having a wire. So I definitely appreciate that it's completely wireless. The eSight 4 does come with a remote, which is much, much smaller. And this will definitely be easier to put in a pocket or a purse. But also the eSight 4 has a touchpad on the side of the device. So even if you don't have the remote, you can still use the device without it using this touchpad. And it has two buttons here on the side. Here are the two remotes. I'm gonna put them close together. You can see if I put them on the sides, the eSight 3's remote is definitely thicker, even if you don't account for the clip. It's a lot more thicker and it is also much wider. But for me, the eSight 4 remote is definitely a lot easier to use. The eSight 3 has all these dials on the side, as well as these buttons on the side, and you can even push down these dials that are on the side, and they have different functionalities, and then there's five buttons on the front. And coming from the perspective of somebody who uses a lot of assistive technology and have tried a lot of different devices, the eSight 4 is definitely a lot easier to use. Another difference is with the battery. With the eSight 3, the battery is in the remote. You could also get like an external battery pack, but you would have to purchase that. Whereas with the eSight 4, the batteries attached to the device, and it's actually reversible, which is cool. You can put it in both ways, and if you shake the battery, it gives you a light indication of the battery level, but it comes with two batteries, and then you can purchase more of these batteries. So that is something pretty cool. Another thing is you can change these batteries while you are using the eSight. While it's on, it's called a hot swap, and you just take off the battery, pop a new battery in there, and it doesn't turn off the device or anything like that, because the actual eSight 4 device has a built-in battery that lasts 5 to 10 or 15 minutes, so that you're able to swap that battery out. That seems like a really great feature when you're using the eSight 4 continuously and to keep doing what it is you're working on. The screens on the eSight 3, the resolution is 1024 by 760, and the eSight 4 has a screen resolution of 1280 by 960, so the screen resolution has definitely gone up. The screens on the eSight 4 can be 2 times as bright as the eSight 3. The eSight 3 has an 8 gig SD card, whereas the eSight 4 has over 200 gigs built-in storage. Both have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth to connect with a Bluetooth headset. Both have an HDMI connection, so you can take a video feed into either or. And both of them support USB Type-C connection, which I definitely appreciate in assistive technology. One interesting difference is the eSight 3 has a 21.5 megapixel camera, whereas the eSight 4 has an 18 megapixel camera. So the megapixel has actually gone down on the eSight 4, but eSight says that this is to do a better match and enhance the quality between the camera and the lens. I honestly can't really tell a difference between the two cameras with my vision. If you have a lot more usable vision, I'm not sure if you'll be able to see that or not. I personally can't tell the difference. The eSight 4 also has a lot more features through the new eSight app, where you can mirror the screen from the eSight to your phone, so you can show family and friends what you see through eSight, but you can also do the other way around, where you can show your phone screen on your eSight, so you can look through the eSight and see your phone. They're still working on making more phones compatible with that, and that's all wireless. And through the app, they have a remote, so you can control your eSight through the app, which is pretty cool if you've lost the remote or you just don't have it with you. You can also pass pictures from or video from the eSight 4 to your phone or vice versa. It also has an e-reader where you can send PDFs to the eSight 4, and you can view the PDF on the eSight 4 and zoom and magnify and use filters with it. And that app works with the eSight 4 only. Now, when it comes to using them as magnifiers, I definitely like the eSight 4 better. The colors are more true to life, and you can have it a lot brighter which I really appreciate, and it also has more contrast and auto brightness. Another big difference is the narrator, the verbal feedback. On the eSight 3, it does have a type of screen reader that reads out the menus to you, but the eSight 4 has a better voice and a better speaker, so it definitely sounds a lot nicer on the eSight 4 and going through the menus. And the user interface is just so much more friendly, and I really like how they have changed that experience in the UI, and it's just a lot easier and more intuitive to use. So if you're interested in learning more about the eSight 4, you can watch my video. Again, I'll leave that in the description, or you can call eSight at 1-855-837-4448, or you can email them at help@eSightEyewear.com. Their website is eSightEyewear.com, and they should be able to help you with any questions or if you want to try out the eSight 4. So that's it for this one. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up below, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell for more videos on technology and encouragement for people who are blind and visually impaired. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I will see you in the next video.